Well, good evening and welcome to Grace Community Church's All for the Families Hymn Sing. We hope you're all doing well, staying home, being safe, being cautious, but not freaked out because God is still in charge. And we're here again to sing some of the old hymns and maybe one new hymn, if it's even a hymn at all. But I think it's the last song is a great message to all of us. We brought some of our young friends back here behind us. You got Michael and Matthew Cunningham who are here to play along with us. So we got some young people playing with some old people playing some old hymns, and that's going to be a fun way to spend a Wednesday evening. So I hope you're sitting down somewhere comfortable and you can sing along with us. The first song we're going to sing is a song called Blessed Assurance. It was written by Fanny Crosby, and it was interesting to find out. I knew that she was blind, but I didn't know that she had lost her sight at a young age, and it was only because she had gotten an infection in her eye. And the doctor was applying what they called poultices back in the day, hot poultices, which is like a mud or a plant or a clay, and it's wrapped in a cloth, and they would put them over the eyelids. Well, it took care of the infection, but it left scarring on her eyes, which left her blind for the rest of her life. And it was just a few months later when her father died. And so she was looked after by her grandmother, who inspired her and pointed her towards the Bible and spending time in the Bible and reading the Bible. And then one day her friend Phoebe Palmer Knapp came over to her home, and she was telling her about this song that she wrote called Blessed Assurance. And she asked how it went, and she said, "Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine." And from there, her friend Phoebe Knapp went and put the music to the words of the song that Fanny Crosby wrote. So this song was written in 1873. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, purchased of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior day long. Perfect submission, perfect delight, visions of rapture now burst in my sight. Angels descending bring from whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. Perfect submission, all is at rest. I and my Savior am happy and blessed, waiting lost in his love. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Praising my Savior. Well, this next song is a great song. It has some great words in it, and it's really talking about being within the veil of Christ. And it was if any of you out there are Irish, it comes from an Irish native named Charity Lees Bancroft, and she wrote it in 1863. And it was introduced in the U.S. in 1865 in a collection of songs entitled Praises of Jesus. And I think from what I understand, Charles Spurgeon quickly got it into his hymn book and started singing it in his church early on. So this song is called Before the Throne of God Above, and it was written in 1863.
Before the throne of God above, I have a strong, a perfect plea, a great high priest whose name is love, whoever lives and pleads for me. My name is graven on his hands. My name is written of the guilt within. Upward I look and see him there who made an end of all my sin. Because a sinless Savior died, my sinful soul is counted free. For God the just is on him and pardon me, to look on him and pardon me. Hallelujah, hallelujah, praise the one risen Son. Spotless righteousness, the great unchangeable I am, the King of glory and of grace. One in himself, I cannot die. My soul is purchased by his blood. My life is hid with Christ on
my Savior and my God. With Christ my Savior and my God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, praise the one risen Son of This last song we're going to do is a song, it's a fairly new song, written by a young man named Jared Anderson. And I don't know if you'd call it a hymn, but when I hear this song, I think of what's going on in the world today with this virus that's out there. And the words are really great. It says, I'll be the carrier of love and compassion. I'll be the carrier of light to the world. I'll be the carrier of hope and salvation. I will go shine your light to the world. And, you know, we hear, as soon as you turn on the TV, you hear about somebody in this world that has been a carrier of this virus. And, well, that's what we want to be, but we want to be carriers of God's word to other people in this world. So that's what this song is really about. So this is a great song called Carrier by Jared Anderson. And I think it was written in 2009, so not very long ago.
Spirit of the Lord is upon me to preach good news to the poor, to bind up the brokenhearted, and make you known even more, so the people living in darkness will see the grace. And I'll be the carrier of love and compassion. And I'll be the carrier of light to the world. And I'll be the carrier of hope and salvation. I will go shine your light to the world. I will go shine your light to the world. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me, freedom and truth to proclaim. Trade your for the oil of gladness, and your sorrows for garments of praise. And I'll be the carrier of love and compassion. And I'll be the carrier of light to the world. And I'll be the carrier of hope and salvation. I will go shine your light to the world. I will go shine your light to the world. Here am I, send me, send me. Here am I, send me, send me. Send me, send me. Here am I, send me, send me. And I'll be the carrier of love and compassion. And I'll be the carrier of light to the world. And I'll be the carrier of hope and salvation. I will go shine your light to the world. I will go shine your light to the world.
Well, we hope you all have a wonderful night. We hope you enjoyed those hymns and that were shared. As I was singing through the song, I was just thinking of the missionaries that we've had that have come out of this church, and we just pray that they're doing well, that they're being healthy and keeping themselves busy, sharing God's word all over the world. And we thank them for what they're doing, leaving their families wherever they may be. And we just ask that God just continues to lead them and just to fill their hearts with His word, and as well as all of us. So thank you. Have a great night, and we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.